We are honoring one of my favorite people in this entire world, Dr. Richard Kahn. He knows how challenging it's been to put the symposium together, but the reward of this whole thing for me is that on the very first one, we will get to honor someone who's given this school so much. I think by now he thinks Judy and I are having an affair because she's been talking in the bathroom on her cell phone and she leaves the room when I call and there's emails and all of the above. So to end this suspense, I would like Judy to come up here and present to him the surprise that he's not expecting so that he can hopefully enjoy.
Hi, everybody. I'm Judy Kahn, and this is our oldest granddaughter, Danielle, who's almost 13, Jessica, who's 10 and a half, and Maddie, who's 5. And I want to thank everybody in the dental community for being here today, but I also want to thank our dear friends not in the dental community for being here on this kind of a long day. They've been here very early, and so thank you all for coming. Our friends not in the dental community have a little surprise for Richard, and they are
Uncle Bob.
Bob Schuster. Steve Liebowitz.
Leonard Pearlstein.
Leonard Pearlstein. And
Leon Unterman.
So if you four could come up here now, thank you.
Well, this is not really only a special day for Rick, it's a special day for us. Many of us have known Rick over the 48 years. We have some people that are up here that know him over 50 or some odd more years going back to high school and grammar school days. It's my honor and privilege to acknowledge Rick as one of our our best friend. He's always there for us. He's always there for the students. It's we just love him, and we're, you know, really thrilled to be here today. And we have something for you to come up here. But this is just a little memory of the day to look back on. What a wonderful day.
Thank you. I just dropped the. Thank you so much.
Okay.
There is surprise number two.
Okay. Let me open it and then I'll.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
So while you're opening that, we're going to really unveil what the affair has been all about. Oh, a lot of people have collaborated on this, and we have a very, very special video for you that is going to speak for itself. We naturally had to edit it and re-edit it, because if we wanted the footage of what everyone wants to tell you, I think, how long was it, Judy? 6 hours and 15 minutes? So there's a 15 minutes of how people whose lives you've touched feel about you. And I hope that you will enjoy that. And that would be our gift to you from the Century Club, from the school, from the symposium, from all of us who love you.
I am Dr. Rex Ingram, class of 1941, and founding chair of the Department of Clinical Restorative Dentistry at USC. A great deal can be said about Dr. Kahn's contributions to the profession of dentistry and to dental academics. Rick, I am fully aware of your academic career, and it has already spanned a period of over 4 decades. But for the welfare of our undergraduate student body and the prestige and stature of the School of Dentistry, please continue to teach your chosen field of clinical dentistry for many, many years to come. I wish to extend my congratulations and personal best wishes for all of the significant contributions you have made to USC and our profession.
Hi everyone, I'm Judy Kahn, Richard's wife. Thank you all for being here today. I know, probably above anyone else, how much the USC School of Dentistry means to him. I have seen firsthand the early mornings, long days, and late nights of working to certainly try to improve dental education at USC. I think most of all, he's proudest of our children, our grandchildren, and our friends and family. These friendships span over 50 years, many of whom are here today. Thank you all for being here. All of you fill our lives with love, happiness, and joy. We love you all. To spend when you get to tomorrow. Here comes the setting sun. The seasons are passing one by one. So gather moments while you may. Collect the dreams you dream today. Remember, will you remember the times of your
USC, the name Rick Kahn, and excellence in clinical dentistry go hand in hand. It was only natural that Rick would be recognized in this first USC International Restorative Dentistry Symposium for his many years of contributions to clinical dentistry.
His dedication to USC School of Dentistry cannot be matched or surpassed. He's a hands-on dentist who is a true teacher. He would rather teach than chair a department. He has been a role model to literally thousands of dental students and dentists alike.
I think Rick Kahn represents the best of what dentistry has to offer, both in exceptional clinical skills, consistency, and his dedication to very, very high standards. And this has been replicated, fortunately, by many students over the years.
In dentistry, you can talk the subject, but quite often, some other faculty can't actually do what they say. Rick was totally capable of doing everything he said and can also take a student who doesn't have the skill sets or didn't understand and take him to the next level because of his teaching skills. He is truly an educator in addition to being a dentist.
He's been, to me, the person who has I've aspired to be like. He is an incredible dentist, clinician, teacher, the consummate educator in dental education. As far as I know, he's the best there is.
Rick has always practiced the same way that he taught in the school, with doing everything as thoroughly and exactly as he taught it. I think one of the measures of his success as a practitioner is that now, 9 years after he stopped practicing, the patients still ask about him, his family, his wife Judy, and the treatment that I see is still there, very durable and very successful.
Oftentimes when I'm in situations where I wouldn't really know how to make a decision, I ask myself, what would Rick do? And I think that there are thousands of us that have gone through the School of Dentistry who on different occasions on a daily basis tend to ask themselves, what would Rick do? Frankly, his voice is ingrained in my brain as I do procedures.
For 44 years, he has dedicated himself to clinical excellence in the way he teaches, in the way he models clinical excellence, and the way he somehow has that magical gift to bring out the best in each of us.
What makes Rick such a wonderful human being is his openness, his warmth, his compassion, his discipline, and I think above all, his respect for the people he works with and interacts with.
Rick and I have been friends for about 30 years. We've become very good friends. We've done a lot of things together. We spend a lot of time together. And I must say, he's an interesting guy who I've come to appreciate in many, many ways.
Richard is one of my closest and dearest friends. There's not a person that I know who I respect and admire more than Richard.
I want to share with everybody the great pride I have in my brother and his accomplishments. Not only his accomplishments, but he is a man, a husband, a father, a grandfather. He is really exemplary and the type of person that everybody would like to model their life after.
Hi, my name is Danielle. I am 12 years old. Richard Kahn is my grandpa. Not only is he an amazing dentist and teacher, he's an excellent grandpa. He's so loving and caring. I love getting to spend time with him. Last summer, he took me and my whole family to Hawaii. I loved spending a week with him. All the times I spent with him are irreplaceable to me.
Hi, my name is Jessica. I'm 10 years old. Richard Kahn is my grandpa. He's not only a dentist, but he's a grandpa too. He's a wonderful grandpa. I remember when I was little and I used to sleep over at his house. Whenever I got scared at night, he would always come into my room and he would stay there for however long I needed it. I know that now, however old I am, no matter when, no matter how hard it is, I know he'll always be there to help me.
Hi, my name is Madison, and I'm 5 years old, and what I like about, and Richard Kahn's my grandpa, and what I like about him is he's not only a wonderful dentist, but he's a great grandpa, and I love him.
The first thing that I think of when I think of my father is how welcoming and supportive he was to me. From the first time Dana and I started going together until today and our family, he has always made me feel like a son and never a son-in-law. And I have felt warm and welcomed into the family.
He was always very patient, very loving, very kind when he was teaching me anything. And he showed me how to ask questions and be curious. He was the one who always wanted to take out the encyclopedias at dinner time and look up little facts about things we may have been discussing at dinner, or dragging me to look at the kitchens and the restaurants we were out just to kind of see what they were making and how they were making it. And I think it's all those traits that probably made his students respond so well to him and certainly made him a fabulous father to me. His relationships with his family and his friends really did come first. He was a fabulous husband to my mom. They have an amazing marriage. They've really modeled that for me. A wonderful father to Brian and I, a wonderful father-in-law to David, and an amazing grandfather to Danielle, Jessica, and Madison. And I'm very appreciative. And I love you very much, Dad. Congratulations.
And I love you very much. Congratulations.
Hi, Rick. I remember first meeting you in the Flatiron building about 40 years ago, or maybe more, and I thought you were just an amazing student, and you haven't proven me wrong through the years. I appreciated everything you did then, and I respect what you're doing now.
Enjoy the day and the tribute that you so richly deserve, and I look forward to your return to school from your much-needed sabbatical, so I can continue to learn from you and with you how to make our School of Dentistry excellent.
Over the years, I've had the good fortune to get to know most of the people who teach ethics and professionalism in dentistry, and you are an exemplar of what those people are trying to teach.
One day you'll be on a bronze plaque in our school, because I know you're one of the greats, and you have a tremendous legacy already, and you'll be a legend for our school.
I want to take a moment to just congratulate you for everything, and know that you and Judy can reflect on major contributions for all of us, and look forward to much more in the future.
You have been an inspiration to thousands and thousands of dentists that have graduated from the University of Southern California School of Dentistry, taking their continuing education programs. These dentists are serving the Southern California community, they're serving the world, and enhancing the dental care and the oral health of our population. Thanks in a large part to what you've done to teach them about quality clinical dentistry.
Your professionalism, your sticking to standards, your demanding that I keep up the standards also has helped me to become closer to the teacher I want to become. So I thank you for that.
I just want to thank you for all those times when I came to you late at night, when you were just about to walk out and you spent half an hour or 20 minutes with me detailing through every single little minute question I had about some principle or some tooth or some prep or something else like that. No matter how late it was or how much you had to run, it seemed like you always had that extra 10, 15, 20 hour, whatever it took, to give me, to help me along my way. And I'll always be indebted to you for those moments that were so important to me.
I'm pretty sure that I could say that you're to me like a father. And I know that a lot of people graduated from this school could say the same thing, that you were not only a faculty member, a teacher to them, you're more than that. You were trying not only to teach us how to be a better dentist, you were trying to show us as an example of your own life how to be a better person, how to be a better man, how to be a better husband, how to be a better father and a grandfather and just a human being.
You've made such a difference in my life, and you've passed on your legacy, excellence, commitment to doing the right thing for my generation and future generations.
Knowing you for the past 21 years have been such a comfort for me. Whether I was a student or became your faculty, or more importantly now as your friend and someone who you've mentored for all these years, I think I've accomplished a lot, and a lot of it is because of you.
Shelley and I want to offer you our congratulations. We wish you nothing but good health and happiness forever. And Richard, we love you dearly.
Richard, I'm really happy to be your brother and very, very proud and honored to be able to talk to you on this video today. And I'm so glad that you're being honored and recognized for all of your contributions.
Dad, you're a very unique person, I think. You're probably the most humble person I've ever been around or been associated with. And I really respect that you take your job so seriously and you've accomplished so much with it, not to gain money or status. And those things have never been real important to you. But you work so hard and you're so good just from the pure basic level of doing the right thing and doing your job properly and helping other people, your students, do their job properly. These examples, though never pushed on me, I think have been the most important and beneficial thing I've learned from observing you for all these years. I don't think I could ever emulate you and be exactly like you, nor probably should I be, but these examples have helped me in my life and made me a better person and made me more successful. And I just want to thank you for that, and congratulations, and I love you.
Personally, honey, I want to thank you for all of our wonderful friends and family. You have truly given me just a wonderful, wonderful life. I love you, and I'm so proud of you. Congratulations.
We love you, Grandpa!
I prepared something, but not for this. I'm almost speechless. I'm sitting there, you know, crying a little. I want to thank all of you for spending your time to come here. And I know it's a Saturday, and some of you took your time away and came in really early because of the football game. I really appreciate it. I don't know what to say. And I really thought I had something prepared, and I was going to introduce my family. But they introduced themselves, and although I wasn't going to introduce each one of my individual friends, that you mean so much to me, so very much. Thank you for coming. I've said this to a lot of people, and I really mean it sincerely. The most important things in the world to me have been my family, my wonderful family, and my wonderful friends. And I think that, to me, is the most important thing. Yes, I'm, you know, I've been at school for a long time, and I guess you get honors like this if you just can stick it out long enough, maybe. You know, it's been 48 years that I've been at USC School of Dentistry, 44 as a faculty member, and I can tell you I'm privileged to have been there. I don't deserve this honor. I really don't. I should be giving the honor that people tolerated me for this many years, and that I really mean that. It's been a wonderful, wonderful experience. And there are some people I want to thank. As I said, I was going to introduce my family and some of my friends and things like that, so that's been done. It wasn't that wonderful. Now I know what you guys were whispering around about. But I do want to just say, and some of these people aren't here, but I want to thank people. Rex Ingram, Rex, you saw at the beginning, he was my teacher, a mentor. We didn't always agree. We still don't. But he set the standard for me in excellence, for how to run a department, to participate in in-service education for faculty. I mean, I think he really set the standard for me, and I really appreciate it. John Engel, who is not here, unfortunately, he's retired in the San Diego area, but he was the dean when I was first appointed to the faculty, and he later had the courage to take a 30-year-old kid and appoint him as chairman of operative dentistry, following in the footsteps of Rex Ingram, who was a legend. Took a lot of courage, and he took a lot of heat for it. There was, you know, religious slander about it, and a lot of things that he really stood up for me, and I greatly appreciate it. A wonderful, wonderful dean and individual. And I'd like to introduce a couple of people, because if I've contributed at all, and you know, I've had the pleasure of educating in some small way, giving something to over 5,000 students in my career, and you know, it's been wonderful. But you don't do that by yourself, and you don't do it in a vacuum. And there's a couple of people, and I don't mean to slight anybody, because all of the faculty, my colleagues over the years, have just contributed so much. And some of them I mentioned in my presentation. But there's some others that I would like to mention. I'll kind of do it in some order here. Lynn Kagihara. Lynn, I don't know where you're sitting right now. There, she's way back there. Lynn Kagihara is very special to me, and although our friendship has been, you know, not real close, but she still always will be and has been a great friend. But Lynn joined the faculty in 1972 when she graduated. I asked her to come and teach full time. That was unusual. Women weren't usually teaching. Lynn is a very special person because she did a couple of things that are so important to our school. Lynn and I were the first ones to develop evaluation criteria at the School of Dentistry. There was never any evaluation criteria. I know some of you who were here before that realized that, you know, people just said that was good or bad or A or B or something. We now have criteria. It's because of Lynn Kagihara that we did this. And the sensitivity we have to teaching and behavior and how we relate to students, a lot of that comes from Lynn. And I mean, she taught me so much, even though she was one of my students. Believe me, she taught me so much, and I really appreciate it, Lynn. And then following that, a few years later, another individual joined our faculty. And you'll notice the theme here is that I chose young people to teach with. And I guess I related to these young people very well. And that was Mike Bryman. And I asked Mike to come in and teach when he just graduated. I asked him to join the practice as an associate in my office. He came full-time. And Mike was so instrumental in helping us develop some organization. The faculty and the administrators who are here will appreciate this. He introduced student evaluation on a daily basis for those students in operative dentistry. We evaluated students every day and computerized it. And now, that doesn't seem very hard now, although we can't do it yet. But at that time, We had punch cards. I don't know if you know what punch cards are, but a form was filled out, and they had to go over to a computer center, and they were punched by hand and then run through a computer. And I could get on my desk every day a report on what the students had done, what grades they received, where they were at that time. And that's because of Mike Bryman. And what a team we were, Mike, Lynn, and I. I mean, it was wonderful. We were all young, enthusiastic, and we really did a lot. Really did a lot, and I'm so appreciative of it. And then a little later, Ralph Leung joined the faculty in 1980, and I don't know, think Ralph is here, but I must mention him, because Ralph was in really the bonded restoration material. He was so inspirational, and he took us a step further in our evaluation process. And we went from what Lynn and I had developed to, in the 1980s, Ralph introducing what we are presently using. The criteria of evaluation that we presently use was developed in 1980, 82, 83, right in that range. And we're still using it, and it's still very effective. And so Ralph helped us so much. And then I know Patty Ryan is here. Patty, where are you sitting? There she is. You know, once again, I chose somebody right out of school. One of the most talented individuals you could ever meet, a great student. But what she really had was a love of people and wanting to help people. And she taught me so much about love and relating to students. And I can honestly say this from all of you who are here and all the students I've had in the past and present, I've learned so much more from my students than I could possibly have given out. I mean, every day you come to school or I come to school, I learn from them. It might be something as simple as how to relate to a student. It might be something about my religion or somebody else's religion. It's just been a wonderful, wonderful experience, and I'm so appreciative. Then more recently, and really I know I'm leaving out a lot of people, but more recently, when I took over as the co-chair of Division 4, I asked a friend to join me in helping in the restorative department, and he graciously accepted, and that's Gary Harmetz. And I don't, there he is. Over there. Gary's become such a good friend and contributed so much in a very short period of time and has really touched our school in many ways, and I thank Gary for all of that. And how could I leave out, once again, a young man, one of my students, a friend, a colleague, and that's Abdi, for kind of egging me on and kind of pushing me a little bit for participating. And he didn't beg, but you know, he asked me if he could have this luncheon in my honor. And I first said no, if Abdi will tell you. And I came home and Judy said, that wasn't very nice. and Judy's usually right. And so I called Abdi back and I said, just don't embarrass me. And I wasn't embarrassed, but I'm very humbled by this video and what people have said. I don't think I'm. It's
there's six more hours of that.
Yeah. Okay. Right. And of course, you know, I have to thank all of the students of the past and of the present, because that's why I'm here. And if I've been able to play some small role in their education, it's all been worthwhile. I've loved it. I can't say that I haven't had my moments of not being happy. I have. We all go through that. But in general, it's been wonderful. And I appreciate it and thank all of you once again for coming here. And now you might think, well, he's forgotten one person. And I haven't. And that's my wife. Because I'm saving the best for last. Judy is the love of my life. She's my lover, my friend, and my advisor. She's usually right.
I seem to be kind of impulsive of doing things, and she's the one who kind of steadies me. She's tolerated my moods when I come home and I'm frustrated, angry, depressed, and has always been there and supported me. And thank you, honey. And I want to thank you, all of you, again. Thank you for being here. You know, I'm always looking at my watch to stay on schedule. But, you know, right now I don't give a damn. So thank you very, very much. Thank all of you.
All of a sudden, you know, I was all under the stress of, is the projector going to work? And we've had behind the scenes all our AV stuff, as Michelle would tell you, being here till midnight, and that pixel is not looking good. So all of it seems meaningless after a ceremony like this. But because I do have to go there and get ready, I just wanted to thank Rick and Judy for just letting this happen. All of you who know Rick well, you know he did it because of us, not because of him. He certainly does not like to be in the spot that he was today. So thank you, Rick. And thank you very, very much for making all this happen. And Judy, I cannot thank you enough. This would not be the same without you. And now that we know we can keep a secret, we're gonna part two.